How do you want to start it?
I don't know, should we play music or something like we usually do?
Yeah, I don't know. Load something up.
What did you want? What should we play?
I mean, you know what I want.
I don't, actually.
Are you kidding me? The music I play every fucking time.
Oh, okay. Hold on. Whew. It's been a while. It's been a while since you did one.
Even Jackie knows.
Hold on, it's playing the ad. Hold on. Yeah. Come on, let me skip it. Alright. Hold on. We gotta hit play first. Fine, no, go back to the... Don't start it. Alright, whatever. Alright, tell me when you're ready.
I'm ready.
Okay. And go.
Good call.
It's only 23 and a half minutes. Kind of feeling it right now.
Oh.
I like the way I had it fade out like that. Usually just hit stop. That's
gentlemen,
professional.
Gentlemen, welcome to the Beast Boys fantasy football draft recap show thing. It's your boy, Richie Fox, commissioner. Jeremy.
Jeremy, the Juice, the Suburban Sledgehammer, a.k.a. the regular season champion.
Damn right.
How has this been, the video been going for 2 minutes already?
Candy shop.
That would have been like this whole song.
We don't really have any plans per se. We're just going to kind of go with it. Figured we'd talk about maybe some of the winners from the draft. Some of the many losers from the draft.
Because obviously, you know, before the season even starts is the best time to analyze how the draft went.
Correct. Yeah.
Before anybody's actually played a down.
Exactly. I mean, yeah. So, I figured, I don't know, who you want to start with? The guy that won it? Or
who won it? Are you talking about the regular season?
No, well, we can.
I mean.
Fuck it. Do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So we're going to go. Let's just start off with who's going to be the number one seed. Who actually has the best team?
Me.
So we'll go with that. Jeremy, go ahead. And what do you think about your team?
You know, I'm looking at it right now. I kind of forgot who most of everyone I picked was.
Go ahead. Well, you have. I have a Chubb and you have Nick Chubb.
Yeah. Well,
so
I mean,
right there, it makes a lot of
I'm
sense.
I'm not going to name my team after someone who's not on my team.
That yeah. Like, I don't know. Sense. Team McFadden.
He doesn't have Darren McFadden.
That's the best
that
he can do.
That makes no sense.
He told me, oh, I'm off of work for 6.5 years. Apparently, he doesn't have enough fucking time to think about a good team name. You piece of shit.
Dude.
I wonder why he hasn't won a championship.
God.
All right. Go ahead.
What were we talking about? Yeah, so obviously, you know, Nick Chubb in the first round.
I love your quarterback. Let me just cut right to that.
I mean, listen, he fell to me in round, I don't remember what round I took him in, but too late to be taking him.
I believe.
Is it seven?
So if I told you, hey, you took Devin Singletary or Tom Brady, who would you have taken first?
Tom Brady.
No, you took Devin Singletary before Tom Brady. That's how late you got him. Yeah, you did, actually.
God, I was drunk.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Eighth round?
God, you guys are stupid.
That's great value.
Unbelievable. And I didn't, you know, I could have gone with the Brady Bunch, you know, because that team name hasn't been done a million times, but no, I switched it up.
Not to mention, you don't want to do anything. Like, name anything after what Steve has already done.
Fuck no.
It's literally the word. I mean, he found it, though.
That's true. Yeah. I think he found fantasy football in general. I think he's the reason we play.
Yeah, fucking hate that guy.
I mean, just the rest of my team is just unbelievably stacked. James Robinson, Justin Jefferson. I mean, like, T. Higgins. I mean, that guy.
I don't know how we let him slip to you.
His name is T. His name is T, as in TDs. That's all he scores. Jesus Christ. I mean, I might go undefeated in the regular season and then lose my first playoff game, but it's safe to say I've got the regular season championship wrapped up once
absolutely.
Again.
And if
hang the banner from the rafters.
And judging
now,
by your roster, I would say who's most likely to get suspended first?
Probably. I mean, I've got Will Fuller on my bench who's already suspended, so could he get suspended again? Possibly.
So,
Justin Jefferson, He looks, not because he's black, but he looks like someone I could see getting an assault charge.
This is going to definitely be at least a 25-minute video, just so everyone fucking knows.
We're already 5 minutes in, and we're just only talking about my team.
And he's not done
And this actually, I don't feel like this should probably be the end of the video.
What else we can end it right there.
Yeah.
As well.
Yeah, you know.
Good team. All right, so
solid.
I figure let's give it to James. Let's move on to James. He won the trophy.
Did he?
Yeah, he did.
Nice stuff.
He won the
it was a regular season.
He won the Feeney. I can't believe that wasn't an outburst. Figure let's go to his team. Let me load it up. Let me load up the draft board. Give you some picks here.
You still have the same
Najee Harris team. He chose a second round running back in the first round. Tyreek Hill beats kids.
Jesus Christ, his team sucks.
AJ Brown, I think, isn't playing this week. Mark Andrews. Deontay Johnson.
I thought that was Duke Johnson.
Miles Gaskin, Lamar Jackson. I mean,
how did
Lamar Jackson some value because I think Mr. Russo took him like a pick four last year. Yeah. So I mean, that's good value in the seven.
Yeah.
So
how did James win the league last year?
I don't know.
His team is awful.
Oh, look at me! I wrapped up the Denver backfield. Oh, never mind. Phillip Lindsay doesn't even play for them anymore. What a shitty team.
Yeah, what kind of idiot
what
has
a shitty person?
What kind of idiot has a Houston running back on their bench? Oh, you've got to be pretty bad at fantasy football.
I'm a doctor and I drive a Corvette.
Yeah, ooh.
He's one of those people that when he pulls up to your house, you just don't look forward to it.
At the end of the day. I wouldn't answer the door. I'd let him keep knocking.
Seriously. I don't know why the screen keeps doing that. So
I mean, if this was fantasy beat your children league, you would got the number one overall pick, Tyreek Hill.
Absolutely.
You are absolutely killing it. So. But unfortunately, we haven't changed that yet. Maybe next year.
All right.
You fucking idiot.
What do you think? Second place? Spawn? The best he's ever going to do in the league.
You mean 0-1?
Exactly. Exactly. Go. You know what? With that being said, go ahead and break it down.
Yeah. Okay. Jalen Hurts. Yeah, it's going to hurt when I fucking beat that ass.
God damn.
Christian McCaffrey. Oh, a white running back. Yeah, because that works out. Mm. Fucking Daryl Henderson.
He has Amari Cooper, dude, who Steve really wanted to trade for before the season even started.
That's crazy.
I wonder why Steve would have interest in Amari Cooper. It's almost like he sucks the dick of somebody else who really loves the Cowboys.
That's news to me.
That's so weird.
Okay, you do have Darren Waller. That's a solid pick. He is a two-time regular season champion at tight end, so good pick there. Robert Woods.
Good pick 6 years ago. Jesus.
Yeah.
The fuck are you living in?
Who the fuck
in?
Is that kicker?
2011?
McPherson? Cincinnati? The Broncos defense.
Did we already go over the fact he chose McCaffrey, Ridley, back to back guys in his division, not on a shitty ass team?
Yeah, what a big Saints fan.
And if you're gonna go McCaffrey, why would you not draft like Cooper Kupp, a white guy? Draft an all white team. I don't care what you gotta
do. How's this feel, Spawn? How's that feel?
That's right.
Fucking idiot.
Fucking what a fucking tool. What a pleb.
How do you work with him?
I would
try to get him fired. I would find reasons to get him fired.
I don't know. Hey, I have a really good idea. Let's draft someone who's out for 10 weeks.
That is a great idea.
Will Lutz. Perfect.
How did you not know your own kicker was out for 10 weeks? I don't think he's a Saints fan.
He must have watched a Super Bowl DVD because he drafted Leonard Fournette. He ran out of players to draft.
Yeah, playoff Lenny.
Good pick. All right. Overall, good team. So let's go.
Pretty good team.
Let's see. Who do we go?
Let's go to you brought up Steve. Let's go to Steve.
Yeah.
Baby got Dak. He really wanted Dak Prescott.
Now,
really wanted
him. Remember?
Probably not.
I don't know.
A lot of alcohol.
The 3 or 4 years ago, Steve's like, I'm going to draft a team with no running backs.
That was last year.
Well, good strategy, buddy. It was so good, he literally fucking reversed it. Literally, he just reversed strategy.
Man, who was
strategy.
His first round pick?
Austin Eckler.
Ooh, ouch.
Ooh, is your hamstring hurting?
I think it is. Oh, jeez.
Jesus.
My God. Jesus. Look, what a garbage fucking team.
I mean, at least he chose someone off my really good roster last year, John Taylor and Clyde Edwards-Helaire.
John Taylor's going to get hurt.
Yep. Clyde Edwards-Helaire is hurt.
Hines is going to get in. Oh, no.
You okay? Uh-oh. Look, she's even sad about Steve's team.
Look at what you did,
that
Steve.
That is Steve's team.
You did this,
shelf.
Steve.
That's
you did
fault.
This.
That's your fault,
This is
Steve.
All on you.
Everything is on
Unbelievable.
You, piece of shit.
Unbelievable.
Yep. Let's see. Odell Beckham Jr.
Receivers fucking suck. His tight end sucks.
Yep. Waddle.
Colts defense?
No, there is one good part of his team. Antonio Brown.
Again, yeah. if this was a criminal fantasy football league.
Yep.
He only has one Jets player?
Oh, man.
I thought you were a Jets fan,
but
dude.
He does have a fucking Dallas player, Dak Prescott.
Oh, yeah. I'm surprised it wasn't his first round pick.
Weird.
Wasn't his first round pick.
All right. Overall, decent team. All right.
Yeah, pretty good.
Yeah, not bad.
Probably have a good year.
Not bad. good running back, though. Yeah. Let's see. Who do we go to next? Who do you want to go to next? Let's see. Let's see. Let's go to the big-ass TDs. Let's go to Shane.
Shane Lake and those big-ass TDs.
Shane Lake and them big-ass TDs. Big-ass
TDs.
All right, what do we got? What do we got? Oh, hey, hey, newsflash. He has Patrick Mahomes.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, were we not watching the same Super Bowl? How the fuck would you want to draft Patrick Mahomes? He didn't even score a touchdown.
None.
Two interceptions, no touchdowns.
Look, she agrees. Horrible, horrible pick.
His career is over.
Shane is famous to me for drafting players who are just about to get injured or not good anymore. Like, right, that's just what he does.
He actually has a pretty good team. He's got Patrick Mahomes and Derrick Henry. How the fuck did that happen?
Yeah, but, I mean...
Keenan Allen sucks. Devontae Adams is going to suck next year when Aaron Rodgers is gone.
No.
Okay. I'd start Jamar Chase.
So Shane...
He's got really good vision.
Shane did have a hell of a quote. I forgot exactly how it went. Not a good start to this. But it was something along the lines of, you have to have insurance. Because he sells insurance. So he likes to have insurance for his players.
Well,
which
he's got
is
three
why
quarterbacks.
He drafted three quarterbacks and two defenses. God forbid the whole football team's defense gets hurt. He has the Ravens to back him up. So that's good. That's good.
Hold on.
Yeah, and I guess I think you're going to have to come get her.
Both your defenses would be going against one of your players.
I mean, you got Matt Gay. I can't fault that.
That's a solid pick. Yep. It's a real woke pick. And I mean, anyone who knows Shane knows how woke he is.
Shane is pretty woke.
He's pretty woke.
I don't know, dude.
He's a damn liberal.
Good team. All right.
Pretty solid.
Mr. Double Double. All right. I'm just going to look at the draft board. Can I do my team?
Sure. This is your show.
Cool. All right. The best team I've ever had on paper. I mean, you look at it. Mike Evans, third round.
That's what sticks out to me.
Mike Evans, third round.
It starts
if I said, hey, you could have CeeDee Lamb, cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
No.
A.J. Brown, good pick, bro. Justin Jefferson had one. Dude, I'm picking Mike Evans all day. I didn't take him too early. I took him too late.
I'm surprised you took Hopkins over Evans.
That's true. I should have taken Evans over Hopkins.
If you look at everybody on your roster, who's the only one there who has a Super Bowl ring?
Exactly.
That's like 50 points right there.
That's a good point. That is a good point.
Yeah.
Then you throw down. I got the Murray Hopkins stack. No big deal. Not a big deal. Then Gus Edwards. Oh, what other running backs are around him? None.
Yeah.
Kidding me right now? Raheem the Dream Mostert.
You got Robbie Anderson on your bench who looks like Sideshow Bob.
Yep. Like Trey Lance, you know, for the hell of it. I mean, why the fuck not?
Why
you know?
Not, dude?
My fucking kicker is dope as fuck. Blanket
shit. He's got those sick ass glasses.
He does.
Yeah, those are sick.
So, no, I'm feeling pretty good about it. I'm looking at it. I don't see a way I don't win my seventh, except for, well, maybe not like regular season championship.
No,
but that's going to this guy. But
no, yeah.
I'm seeing 6-8, 7-7, slip into the playoffs.
Yeah.
Trade James.
Well, James will trade you.
I'll trade James.
Let me see James's team again. Who's he going to trade
Let's forecast that.
Yeah.
Does he have Kelce again?
I'm going to say no. I have
oh,
Kelce.
Oh, yeah, I can't get him.
So you're not getting him.
Let me look at Matt's team just in case James doesn't work out.
I'm going to say either Najee Harris or Tyreek Hill will be on your team by the end of the year.
I can
possibly
see that.
Both.
Yep.
Possibly both.
Yeah, because I'll trade him some super, super good up and comer. Yeah. I don't know, man. Matt's team, I would really, really...
Team.
I could see Alvin Kamara maybe
pulling a
hamstring.
I'm such a Rams fan. I took Matt Stafford. What? Come on,
we're just going to transition into this team?
I thought that's what we were talking about.
That's fine, yeah. That was good.
Like, you just draft him because he's the quarterback of your favorite team? Who fucking does that?
I don't know.
Like, take it seriously, dude.
Not to mention, he reached so high for him. I think he got him in, like, the 12th round. Like, come on,
really?
Dude.
Yeah.
Like, seriously?
See? Like, oh my, good kicker, though. Really good kicker. Solid kicker.
What else we got on Matt's shitty-ass team? Logan Thomas has one good year. Let's draft him.
I know. Oh, wow, dude.
I feel like that's the sound
Cup.
Matt makes just walking
Cooper
around.
Cooper Kupp, of course, yeah. Matt would take the only white receiver, you fucking racist.
Is he the only wide receiver?
Scotty Miller?
That's a good point.
I don't think anybody drafted Scotty Miller, though.
Yeah, that's a good point. Good team.
Yeah, pretty good.
Pretty solid. Pretty good team. Pretty solid. I can't argue. Not a bad team. Probably a playoff bound.
Can't find a weakness.
So, yeah, good job. All right.
I don't remember who we talked about already.
Yeah. Bobby's team we need to do.
CD's
we could just do Steve's team again. That's always fun.
Yeah, let's do Steve's team again.
Baby got Dak.
Yeah, okay.
Baby got Dak. Let's reemphasize his team.
Ooh, Bobby, I took Dak Prescott. Do you like me? Is that a good pick, Bobby?
Hey, Steve, I think Amari Cooper's going
to
be good.
I'm trying to get Amari Cooper. Oh, take the Cowboys plus
350. I'm never getting vaccinated. Never!
He's got a pretty good team.
Yeah, it's not bad.
We didn't do Bobby's yet.
No, we haven't done Bobby's. Yeah. We haven't done Mr. Russo's or Chris's.
Look at Bobby's, and we both know what sticks out immediately. Look at Bobby's team.
Yeah, a lot of Cowboys.
Look who sticks out immediately.
Oh, Russell Wilson.
Yep.
So last year,
I learned my lesson.
I had Russell Wilson.
No, you had him 2 years ago.
Two years ago, you know, when I won the championship for the sixth time, and then. Jeremy drafted him, and I was like, dude, good pick, and I talked a lot of shit.
He did.
Well, the first 8 weeks of the season, Jeremy's like, yeah, he's the MVP, you can go fuck yourself. But the last 8 weeks of the season came up, and Jeremy then realized...
He won me a regular season championship, and then he didn't win me a playoff game, so...
I would get rid of him. Do you have a backup quarterback? Aaron Rodgers, that's a really good pick, dude. Faggot?
Why do you have... Why did so many people take backup quarterbacks before, like, Chris took a starter?
Because Chris has Corey Davis. We'll get to that later.
Yeah, spoiler
Dude,
alert.
Best pick of the draft. Holy shit. Zeke Elliott. Good pick.
CeeDee Lamb.
Mike Davis. I guess we'll see. I don't know. He's the only guy there.
He fucking sucks.
He's the only guy there. You took DK Metcalf over Mike Evans. That was a good pick, bro.
DK Metcalf hasn't even been to a Super Bowl.
Yeah. Name the last time DK Metcalf had 7 straight 1,000-yard
exactly.
seasons.
Exactly.
You can't argue that point.
Yeah,
you know why?
Can't argue.
Because I can make that point every time because no one's done
it. That's right. Not even Michael Irvin.
Oh, and then he's like, oh, man, I've heard about this Kyle Pitts guy. I think he's going to be great.
I was watching ESPN2 and they were talking about him.
Oh, man, he's got a really good athleticism.
Ooh.
Hey, James, what do you think?
He's got a pretty good team, though.
Yeah, it is.
A really solid team. It's a really solid team.
He's going
team.
Dolphins against Mac Jones' first game. I could see it. Makes sense. Then he's got the Browns lined up for next week. That's a good play.
Yeah, you don't want to start the Browns this week.
Well, next week they play the
Chiefs. Actually, no. Yeah, you do want to start the Browns. They're playing the Chiefs. Chiefs have a terrible offense.
That's true.
But it was more a touchdown than the Super Bowl that the Bucs won.
I think they're projected 2.9 points per quarter they play.
I think per possession.
Yeah, per Chiefs possession.
Per Chiefs offensive possession. They're going to get 2.9 points.
Oh, my God. I look for the Browns on the waiver wire because they play the Texans next week. Weren't there. So, just wanted. I don't know why I said that. I just wanted to
Where'd
fit that in
Where'd the kid
go? I don't know. So you made this big deal about writing in. What's this guy's name again?
Yeah, okay.
Marquez Callaway.
You know it's
Callaway.
A good pick when they don't have a fucking sticker for it.
It's like, dude, this guy had one good preseason game. You're like, yep, this is the steal.
I trust Jameis Winston.
Jameis Winston. Draft him, too. Jesus.
Yeah, why didn't you? You draft Aaron Rodgers, but not Jameis Winston?
Juju Smith. Shoot. I mean, he's kicker. I can't argue that.
You can't.
Young Ho. Good team. All right.
Yeah, it is. We already decided. It's got a really solid team.
Very good team. Now, do we go to Mr. Russo or Chris?
Let's save Chris for last.
Yeah, all right. Let's go to Mr. Russo. So, Mr. Russo, what jumps out at me immediately is his first round, he took a running back instead of a quarterback.
That is shocking.
Which I believe is the first
that's
year
a
he's
first.
Done that.
Yeah.
So, that's and Aaron Jones is damn good. Damn good.
Yeah, he does have. He's pretty weak at receiver though. Julio's his number one.
He should start Ron Jones, so he just has the two Joneses in his
you can
running
have three,
back slots.
You can have three Joneses. He's got Julio. That was what I tried to do last year.
Oh.
I tried to have the all Jones lineup last year.
Jesus, that's actually
yeah. Someone
sweet.
Took Aaron Jones one pick before me. I would have had Aaron Jones,
dude,
Ronald Jones,
Mac Jones,
Julio
right?
Jones.
You could have a whole Jones team.
You could have a whole Jones team.
This is dude.
If only there was a team from a city called Jones. I don't think there's a tight end Jones.
Maybe one
that sucks.
You know what? We're only 19 minutes and 53 seconds into this.
Yeah, keep talking. I'm gonna look it up.
So, yep. As Jeremy's looking that up, we'll just go through the rest of the roster here. Honestly, Big Papa has a pretty good team. But by that, I mean it sucks really bad. Joe Mixon, not a bad pick there.
Breaking news.
What do you got?
We have Charles Jones.
Whoa!
He is a free agent, and I don't think he has any career stats.
And he doesn't even have a picture. Yeah.
I don't know if you can see that.
I don't know. It doesn't look good. Let me fix my screen again. There it is. All right. So, yeah. Is there a kicker, Jones? Just don't start a kicker.
Hold on.
Yeah, look it up.
I have the Joneses saved.
So
there is not a kicker named Jones. So. Let's you want to break down the Joneses? Do a power ranking of all the Joneses.
That's not a bad idea.
I mean, we got Julio Jones, Taiwan Jones, Tony Jones Jr., JJ Jones, Zay Jones, Daniel Jones, Tevin Jones, Mac Jones, Xavier Jones, TJ Jones, Marvin Jones Jr., Ronald Jones II, Charles Jones and Aaron Jones. There's actually not as many Joneses as I thought there would be.
Yeah, but where were we with his team? I don't know. Honestly, I don't know.
Whose team are we talking about?
Mr. DeGonads.
Oh, DeGonads. Okay.
Okay. Another thing jumps out at me. Where is Seymour Snatch?
I mean, DeGonads is pretty solid.
I want Seymour Snatch. I think everyone would agree with me.
Yeah.
So
you got a good tight end though.
But no.
Solid tight end.
This year he took a nap after the draft and not during it. And for that, I appreciate you. Good team.
Yeah, we're just a solid team.
And then we'll end it with Chris Russell, the old Scott's Tots. So a lot of things jump out to me here. So it's a team. I don't dislike. It's like it has potential.
Yeah, but so did I. Like, look how I turned out.
Like if Saquon's good, I mean, Gibson's a good pick, no doubt. Godwin, probably the second best pick of the entire draft. I looked at the board. I can't find. Okay, third, Tom Brady.
Yeah,
because you know he wanted Tom Brady. He was like, I didn't want Tom Brady there. I wasn't going to take him. Jesus Christ. But Godwin,
I drafted him and immediately went and bought his jersey.
If Kittle stays healthy, he has a lot of guys that were hurt, are not hurt anymore, could be pretty good. Got that Buccaneers defense. He looks like he's playing them against Dallas. That's a very smart decision. You know why? Because that's one of those decisions that you don't make, but then they score 30 points. Right. It really is, because it makes no fucking sense.
Yeah. It's the Cowboys. The Cowboys fucking suck.
But let me load up the draft board, and I want you to tell me what jumps out at you.
Yeah.
What jumps out there?
I mean, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, the sixth round.
Let's see.
Sixth round.
If I told you, hey, man, you can have any of these players, Dak Prescott, DeAndre Swift, Thielen, Wilson, DJ Moore, Damian Harris, Daryl Henderson, anybody, honestly, or Corey Davis, who would you choose?
I think it's pretty obvious. I mean, you go Corey Davis.
Absolutely.
Plays for the Jets.
Absolutely.
He's got a rookie quarterback. His only ever good season was his contract year last year. It's just production.
Yep.
Production.
Absolutely. Top 10 receiver. Automatic top 10.
Top five, dude. Zach Wilson.
Top three.
He's proven. Just like Sam Darnold.
Top three.
The second the Jets draft him, Hall of Famer. Hall of Famer, proven.
You are so sexy.
Proven. I do what I can.
I mean, overall, good team.
Yeah, pretty solid. Pretty good team.
So, is that everybody? I don't want to end this video and then, like, forget.
Can we go over your team?
Yeah. Yeah, I said the usual. Best team in the league.
Oh,
I'm going to win it again.
You know, 6-7.
Mike Evans.
Squeaky. Yeah,
I can't believe you guys let me have
James
him.
Is going to make a stupid trade, give you his
best
player.
Yeah, we went over that. We covered everything on my team. I just wanted to reiterate, I cannot believe you idiots let me have Mike Evans.
Yeah, we are pretty dumb.
Cool. So like I said, we're about 25 in, but we're not exactly there. So let's just keep going with that.
You gotta drag it out for time.
In all seriousness, I usually there's like one to 2 to 3 teams that like have like really bad drafts and reach for players. This I want to say was the best draft. Like I was gonna do a power rankings, but it's very hard when everyone has a good team and like Jeremy said, no one's played yet.
Yeah.
But if I was gonna do a power rankings, you're number one, obviously, yeah, and I'm number two because you're the regular season champ.
Yeah, clearly.
And yeah. You're gonna have the number one seed, and then I'll do like a playoff power rankings, and then I'm done. You'll plummet.
That's all that matters. You'll make plummet. My money back by weekly bonuses. Play for free. And then I regular season, I just hang the banners, baby.
Maybe we should do a power rankings just based on the people in the league instead.
Just as them as people. Okay, this could be tough.
This is. We're already 25 minutes in. That's fine. I won't argue with you. If you had to pick a number one in this league, who is it? It could be yourself. Doesn't matter. I mean, you're on the board.
I mean, obviously, I think it's pretty obvious. I'd go Mr. Russo.
I was just going to say, I absolutely agree.
Number one pick.
He's number one. He's legendary.
How about we do a draft? We go back and forth. We draft. Exactly. So first pick, I take Mr. Russo.
And that's exactly who I would have taken.
And then it gets tough after that.
It really does.
Yeah.
Holy crap.
Right?
Because I'm not taking myself. I don't belong at this pick. You're solid. So I'm gonna go.
Like you think you she's like, oh maybe them, and then you think about it, you're like, they're actually an awful human being.
So here's why I'm gonna choose this person. Is this guy is not an awful human being. He's like the nicest guy. I've never had a bad interaction with him. It's gotta be Bobby Jarvis. I'm taking Bobby Jarvis number two. He's a nice guy. He's always there to help you. Even today, he's like,
he's talking shit about the Bucks.
I hope. No, but his
way of talking shit. 0-1.
Yeah, but besides anything, I hope.
And then he states,
I hope
and
you
then
guys
he states actual facts that far. Are true.
I hope none of your players get injured.
Yeah, but it's, you know.
The way he goes about things is irritatingly nice. That's the way.
But he's so nice, you know, he does something that we don't know about. He's diddling kids, human trafficking.
That's true. If I actually looking at this list.
He's in the KKK. Like, there's something going on.
Looking at this list, out of the 10 people, he would be my number one pick for human trafficking.
If this was a human trafficking draft, he's number one pick.
I don't take
he's
back.
First
I don't take.
Pick.
I don't take back my pick.
Yeah, all right,
I'm
that's
sticking.
Fine.
I'm sticking with Bobby J. That's my number one pick.
I guess I'm just gonna go with myself as my second pick.
As you should.
I'm not saying I'm great, but compared to everybody else, I'd rather have me.
Yeah, that's a good point. I'm not gonna take myself. Jesus.
Yeah, it's
it's getting very tough. You know what? We needed a guy. We needed a guy. I got us a guy. We needed a guy. I got us a guy. I'm going to go with another nice guy, Matt Spahn. Aside from being a Saints fan, which is a horrible decision, he even regrets that.
He tried to be a Bucks fan.
And he's getting what he deserves. They got Jameis Winston. Good luck with that.
So let me just be clear. You went in back-to-back, you went with a Cowboys fan and a Saints fan.
That's correct.
Just letting you know that.
That's correct.
I'm also pissed.
Which should tell you.
Honestly, I'm also pissed because that was probably my next pick.
he's beautiful. He kind of reminds me of what's his name from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. The main guy.
Dennis?
Yeah. Spahn and Dennis are like
that's
very
awful
similar.
Thing to say.
Why?
Dennis is like a sociopath, like fucking rapist.
Yep.
Okay, yeah, fair enough.
Yep. So I got a child molester and a rapist.
I guess I because, like, there's, you know, people I'm going to go with just because they're Bucks fans, but it's also, but they're also some of the worst people I've ever met in my life. You know, okay, this might be a controversial pick. This is going to be seen as a reach, but A, he's a Bucks fan, and two, he's got some beautiful hair going right now. I'm going Chris Russell.
Wow. Yeah, holy shit. That is a reach.
It's a reach.
That's a Corey Davis.
Some people might have had him pegged as Mr. Irrelevant, but he's my Corey Davis. Just like he drafted Corey Davis too early, I'm drafting Chris Russell too early.
Hey, fair enough. No, I mean, he does have a beautiful set of hair. He's got a nice beard.
He's got some good promoted lettuce at work. He did get promoted, yeah.
Promoted at work. Yeah, obviously has a small penis. Has the two girls going on.
Yeah, yeah. He's making that Skrilla. Yeah.
So, all right, for my next pick, at this point, everyone sucks. Everyone on the board left sucks, including myself. I'm still not picking myself. I'm not picking myself. It's either you or I'm left with myself. And that's usually the way I feel every day.
This is going to be a tough end of
the every draft, day when I wake up in the morning, I have to look at myself.
That's true.
So I don't want myself. And this is straight. This is tough. Give me James Hanshew. I know. Yep.
I was trying to get all the Bucks fans.
Yep. I'm going to go James. You got Bobby and James. They're the duo. And
that is a good 1-2 punch.
Yeah.
That's like what I was thinking. Quarterback receiver combo.
It's like a stack.
Yeah.
It's a stack. That's really what this boils down to.
You're
going to
get the dynasty, though. That's what we're going to find out.
I actually was thinking about not bringing up that point, but I have to.
Are you going for the. Well, I'm saying we'll find out.
But yeah, James is my pick. I want to go more into James. I mean, he's got a Corvette. Yeah. You know, he's got a girl on the way. You know, good for him. What else? He's won the championship. I think in school, if I remember correctly, someone de-pantsed him and his balls were bigger than his penis, and I respect that in a man.
He's got real
nuts. I think that was him. I might be totally wrong about that. I could have sworn it was him.
I don't think I was there for that.
I don't know.
I would have remembered.
I swear it happened. Go ahead.
All right. With my next pick.
Don't do it. Don't. Come on. Give me the three.
I'm taking you, dude.
Oh, what a pick! Thank you!
I'm taking Steve.
Jesus. Why? Go over this pick. Why would you take me?
Because you're a Bucks fan.
All right. Good choice.
You had a nice head. Your penis is average and tanner than your body.
That's true.
Sex vein.
Sex vein. No. Your kids like me better than you.
31 minutes in. Let's do it.
Nobody is watching this.
I don't care. We're doing it for us.
No one's watching this.
I don't care. This is sick.
And then we're gonna rewatch.
I want to do this. I'm gonna do this every week.
What time is it? We've got time to kill. I'm trying to get to fucking 8:20.
Yep.
This day is dragging ass.
And Bobby's gonna need something to do in the second half.
Yeah.
So I'm sorry, Bobby. You're on my team. But
at least you can go golfing.
Well, with that being said,
that's my motto.
It's to be no surprise.
That was my go-to.
What?
With that being said, that's what I always used to say that in videos.
With that also being said. It should come as no surprise. I am going to go with the Italian meat stack, Pimp Steve, Pimp Daddy, Fratty. And let me lay out my case like he laid his dick into Chelsea. You know,
he is the only one having a boy.
I got Bobby.
I got James, and now
I have Steve.
Yeah.
So here's what I'm thinking is Steve is slowly, very slowly improving as a person because he's basically copying my number one, copying what my number one pick is doing. Hey, Bobby has a mullet. I guess I'll have a mullet too. I like old smoky peanut butter whiskey. Like, you know, he's basically going.
Bobby is like the veteran quarterback.
Yeah. Steve's Kyle Trask. Steve is Tom Brady.
Okay. Because that Bobby, you're just like Tom Brady.
Exactly. Exactly. Like, oh, wait. You like Trump? Me too. Like, you know, it's like, I just, it's
we
good.
Have so much in common.
Oh, my God, do we? Oh my God, Steve is the worst.
You picked him.
I know.
All right.
He's gonna be a cancer in my locker
room.
Oh
no! Oh. I just realized there's only one person left.
There's two.
There's two?
Yeah, you picked first.
No, who else is left? No, there's only one left.
There should be two, right?
Oh, is nobody? Oh God, you're right.
Who's not taking?
I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
I mean, listen. With this pick, I'm gonna be up to date on everything that's going on Twitter. I will get all the updates immediately. Pick is Shane, Mr. Double Double Lake.
The big
Diesel Daddy.
The big
Those
Diesel
are
Daddy.
Big ass TDs.
Yep.
No. I'm going to know what happens before anybody else does.
Not to mention, you only have to see him once a year.
That's true.
And that's nice.
Yeah.
Like, that's probably the best part of Shane is I only see him once a year.
Unrelated, Bobby does think his sister is really hot. Completely unrelated, but... You remember that?
Oh, Paige. I thought Shane thought Bobby's sister was hot.
I mean, he probably does. Yeah. I don't know if he's ever seen Bobby's sister before.
I don't know if I forgot. I think I don't remember.
I'd rather fuck Bobby.
Obviously. I'm gonna, that's where that one stops.
You got Mr. Irrelevant.
And you know what? Honestly, I'm okay with this pick. You know, Matt, my boy, he could come up.
This jersey's making me sweat balls.
It would be nice. Well, there's not a lot of good circulation in this room.
Sweat.
You think if I call Steve, he'll put in a new AC unit for me?
Probably.
That'd be nice. Matt. Sorry, Mr. Irrelevant.
Mr. Irrelevant.
You don't even have a team name, which hurts. But, you know, I love me some Matt. I'm happy he got back to me. I'm happy he got back.
What could his team name be?
Yeah.
He's got Cooper Kupp. See, I have Cooper Kupp in another league, and I mean, obviously I went two girls, one cup.
Yeah.
So don't do that. See, Diggs, Stafford, fully staffed.
Oh, that is good.
Yeah.
That's really, did you just come up with that, or did you like look it up?
No, off the dome, dude.
That's awesome.
Off the dome.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, I'd go fully staffed.
That is a good team.
Because, it plays on what's going on in the world, how nobody has, you know, people aren't working.
So, not to mention, if it wasn't for Matt, we may not have had pulled pork at all, because Matt's the one that found the,
I honestly don't know if I had pulled pork, because I was super drunk.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
I puked all of mine in Steve's yard.
And on the side of that
and
gas
on
station.
The side of the what used to be the Exxon. I don't know what it is anymore.
I think it's still an Exxon.
Yeah. But Steve, there's so much vomit in your yard. It's disgusting.
And I still haven't gotten any clam chowder.
So, anything else you want to do? 35 minutes in.
Should we try to get to 40?
You know what? Let's do the whole video again.
But keep it on this. Like, keep it rolling.
Yeah.
Don't stop this video and start over. All right. Let me get Candy Shop going. Hold on. We got a text message from the group. Steve has just sent a picture of... Oh, Rich. Which dog is that?
Oh, my God. I don't know.
Rich, I'll show you guys.
Oh.
I'll show you guys. All right.
It's fucking hilarious.
So, Rich, which dog is that? Which one of Steve's dogs is that?
Oh. I don't know. Okay.
I mean, you got a 50-50 chance.
I know.
That's if you remember the names.
There's Landy and Leo. I think they're both named after Avalanche players.
I don't think Leo is.
Whatever. I think that's Leo. And the reason I say that is I think Landy's got like a reddish tint from what I remember.
I'm not gonna tell if you're right or wrong. When Steve watches. Well, so, this is how we'll know if Steve watched the whole thing. Steve let him know if he was right or wrong.
That's gotta be Leo. I was gonna say Landy because he's taking a shit on land, but it wasn't enough for me to do it. So fuck, it's only 304. It's only 304. Is that a Crystal Love?
Oh, we still filming? I thought we were done.
Oh, Jesus.
Shit, my bad. I thought we stopped.
Anyway. In conclusion.
Yeah, with that being said. The HOA is pulling into the station.
It would.
Who do you think's gonna win the league? No, we got two more minutes to get to 40.
I mean,
all right, rapid fire. I'm gonna tell you the two's playing each other. You're not gonna know any of the teams. You tell me who's winning.
Done.
Ready? Hold on. Go on YouTube. Get the NFL ESPN music playing quickly.
Wait, I don't know. I don't. I'm...
You know, like the fucking, just look at ESPN, NFL,
music.
I don't know if it's theme. Try that, yeah, play that, yeah.
Whatever you're looking for,
fucking ad, dude.
We still got a minute.
We got time.
We got a minute.
Now, and get up to 20% back in travel credits by using promo code
RENTAL20. Did they not let you skip anything anymore?
Welcome back to travel, booking.com.
All right,
go ahead.
In our first matchup of the week, we have the implication Matt Spawn versus I Have a Chubb.
I Have a Chubb, regular season champ.
Right,
go.
Next, Scott's Tots, Chris Russell playing Shane Lake in those big ass TDs.
Shane Lake, he's good in the early part of the season, sucks late. Go.
All right. The Double Orgasm Knights versus Let Me See Your TDs, the random champ.
Me, obviously. Next.
Team McFadden versus Baby Got Dak, Steve Fratty.
Matt, fuck Steve.
And finally, CD's Nuts, Bobby Jarvis versus the Gonads, Mr. Russo.
Mr. Russo.
All right. Look at that. 30 seconds to spare. 30 seconds to spare.
What else can we do?
Care Bears, lucky day.
10 seconds.
A big fat raindrop landed on Grumpy. Come on. Okay. What is happening in that picture? This Care Bear is clearly getting splooged on.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. I never would have picked up on that. All right. I'm we made done. It. All right, guys. If you did watch all this, thank you.
If you like this video, leave a comment. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the reminder.
I will. Yeah, ring the bell. I will not. Bell. I will not.
Leave a comment.
I will not promise share. Videos throughout the season, but once in a while, I'll come
I'm
through.
I'm never. Just the only video I'm gonna be in all year.
How about this? Only when Jeremy comes over will I do a video.
This is the last video of the year.
I'm the love doctor.